Hi, welcome back to Body Beautiful. I'm Janelle Marie, and we are talking about cosmetic procedures today. I've got a plastic surgeon, Dr. Joseph Mele, with me, and we're talking about all kinds of things. And now we are going to talk about cosmetic ear surgery. But I first want to give the phone number out, 415-561-8753, if you want to call and ask the doctor any questions. He will definitely answer them. All right, so let's talk about cosmetic ear surgery. This is so interesting because, you know, I'm reading a lot of people are getting prominent ears reduced. And I'm thinking that's all, you know, the ear procedures there are, but there's more. But we'll talk about that in a minute. But let's talk about prominent ears. So, you know, who needs this done? When you really need to know, who needs it done?
It's an elective procedure. So it's when people are sort of a little self-aware of their ears being out too far, or they can't cover it with hair.
With hair, yeah.
Or they have to cover it with hair because they don't want to see them.
Yeah.
And it becomes a sort of a distraction. Then it's probably worth looking into whether it's worth fixing.
Is it the younger the better, like, you know, to get this done? If parents say,
You know, it's funny. When I went through my training, we would do a lot of this surgery at about age 5.
Yeah.
Before kids went to kindergarten. But now with preschool, kids are going to school earlier and earlier. You want to wait till at least 5 or 6 because the ear is about 85% of its adult size by then.
Oh, okay.
But any time after it can be done.
Anytime after
So I do see, I still see kids, but I also see a lot of young adults and even older folks who just, you know, bugged them but not enough, and now it's bugging them enough where they want to do something about it.
So how do you do it?
It depends on the problem. So the most common reason we have prominent ears is it's not completely folded back.
Mm.
So we have this little fold sort of in the middle of the ear that puts the edge of it backwards.
Yeah.
And that's the last thing to develop on the ear. So sometimes the development in utero just kind of stops a little early and the ear's sticking out. Then we just form that fold and bring it back. Sometimes it's that the bell of the ear where we catch our sound is big.
Yeah.
And sometimes that bell's rotated forwards.
Yeah.
And then we need to rotate it back. So it depends a little bit on what the problem is.
And so do you make a cut behind the ear?
Exactly. So we make the incision behind the ear. All the scar is hidden back there, so
we
don't really see it's there, especially after we brought the ears back.
Yeah.
I think some of the pictures, all the pictures I have, the prominent ears are from behind.
Oh.
And you can kind of see that you don't really see behind the ear as well afterwards because the ears are brought back.
That's pretty cool. Any alternatives to having this done? Let's say people just don't want to go through with that. Can they do anything else about prominent ears?
At birth, you can. So if you have a child and they are like a day old and their ears are really sticking out, you can actually mold the ear because that cartilage is still under the influence of estrogen from the mother.
Right.
And if you get to it in those first few weeks, you can actually change the shape of the ear, but you have to keep it on all the time.
And so if you do get it done surgically, what is the downtime on that? Is it a big deal?
It can be tender.
Yeah.
Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. I always worry when things are painful that there's bleeding, infection, some problem.
Right.
Sometimes it's just sore because the ear is sensitive.
Okay.
Usually the ear looks pretty normal at a week.
Yeah.
If there's bruising, swelling, it takes a few weeks to months for all of that to go away.
But you can hide that with hair, so not a lot of downtime really?
And a lot of my patients are already doing that before.
Exactly.
So it's not a big deal.
All right, good. I want to look at some pictures. I wanted to also talk about torn earlobes because I did tear my earlobe completely.
Nice.
And finally had it redone, but that was a while ago. So it's still giving me a little problems. I should have gone to you, doctor.
Well, sometimes it's traumatic. Like it gets pulled on or your earring gets caught in a sweater.
Yes.
And sometimes it's kind of chronic. If it's a really heavy earring, it may slowly work its way down.
Let's talk about that a little more, but I want to look at pictures.
So here's prominent ears. So here's a gentleman who had his ears
look at that.
Sticking out. He obviously wasn't too worried we wanted to grow his hair long about it.
I guess not.
But he was bothered by it. So what we did is we made the incision right behind the ear, rotated the cup of the ear in, and also that edge of the ear where the fold is not formed. You can see the top of the ear really sticks out more than the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And just makes it nice and
so
even.
So you don't sew it. I mean, you just kind of take some skin out, right, and then sew it back? It's not sewn back on your head or anything.
Correct. It's not it's not stapled onto the skull. It's some of the skin is removed, though, because it helps keep the ear back.
Okay.
But more importantly, that structure inside of the cartilage needs to be changed.
Oh,
the skin
you've got to change that.
The shape. So you put stitches in behind the ear or I'll scrape the cartilage in the front of the ear. Both those techniques allow it to curve
back. Oh, that's amazing. So you really have to change the cartilage a bit. And what about this?
So here's someone who had a piercing in their upper ear.
Oh, yeah.
And some people are born with what's called a Darwin's tubercle.
Yeah.
It actually is a little bump off in that
area.
Yeah, I've seen
that.
But this is a little different. So this was trauma from a piercing. And they were active in sports, so they kept having to take it out to play and back in when they wanted to have it on there. So now they're done with it, and they were left with this bump. So we can make a little incision sort of inside the curve of the ear, carve
Look
out that
cartilage
that forms, and it's similar to like a cauliflower ear.
Yeah.
So this would be like the smallest cauliflower ear I've ever fixed.
It's because people do have get
cauliflower ears. You get hit in the ear, it bleeds out of the skin, and then that blood becomes hard like cartilage.
So you can fix
so we
that
can get
also.
In there and clean that out too.
Oh, here's a torn one.
So here's a torn earlobe.
That was mine. Looked exactly like that. Yeah. So how'd you fix that?
So this is someone who had worn earrings all her life, and eventually it had worked its way down to a very thin piece of skin, and then it tore.
Oh, so it just tore on its own.
Sometimes I see people where the hole is big and the earring's falling through.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's completely torn. And in this case, what has to be done is that skin inside that V has to be removed. So you've got that raw surface to sew back together.
Oh.
And then it heals. So there's a little scar in the front and the back of the ear wrapping around. But you can come back later and re-pierce it. Usually I'll wait about 6 weeks, re-pierce it, and it's good as new.
Mine didn't work its way through. Mine was an actual, I was wearing a hoop and somebody put their finger in and just ripped it completely out. Anyway, I had to tell that story because it's gross.
Sometimes that's easier. You just sew it back up and you're done.
All right.
And here's a younger gal. So she came in with prominent ears, liked to wear her hair up, hard to do.
Yeah, very. But it looks great.
So it just comes right in, looks totally normal.
All right. Sounds
good. And it should last her whole life. It's not the kind of thing that recurs.
Absolutely. I love that. All right. Good information. If you want more information about Dr. Mele, you can call him 925-943-6353. Check him out on the web, drmele.com, or you can go to sanfranciscobreast.com. We got lots more coming up on Body Beautiful. I think we're talking about breast implant revision and later abdominal rejuvenation. All right. Plus, we'll be taking more phone calls. Join us on Body Beautiful. We'll be right back.